Good morning, children. Welcome to your English language class. Okay. As you know, last week I started with chapter 2. Okay. And the name of the chapter is Subject and Predicate. Okay. It is in page number 8. Okay. I hope you've understood because I've already explained. However, I will do a quick recap, okay, or a revision of this chapter. So we are in page number 8. Okay. Just pay attention here. Now, if I say, now look at this sentence. Is this a proper sentence? Okay, remember in chapter 1 we spoke about a sentence also, right? What is a, we learned about the definition of a sentence, and we also learned about the kinds of sentences, right? Now, what is the definition of a sentence? In simple words, it is a group of words which makes sense, which you can understand, right? So when I say the dog is barking, is it a complete sentence? Yes, it is a complete sentence, okay? Now here, in this chapter, we are studying about subject and predicate. So in this, when I say the dog, what is it? This is a subject, okay? And is barking is your predicate, okay? Now, what do you mean by subject? Subject is, you know, tells us who or what the sentence is about. So here it is about the dog, right? We are talking about the dog. So that is why the dog becomes the subject. So what is the dog doing? The dog is barking. So it becomes a predicate. Okay, just understand this only. We know the definition of a sentence, group of words which makes sense, and subject, who's the sentence, what does the sentence tell about? About whom? The dog. So it becomes the subject. What is the dog doing? The action that the dog is doing, barking. So this becomes the predicate. Okay, children? All right. So you can have, one word as subject, or you can have more than one word. Like you have two words here, the dog. You can have, you have in your book this, owl's hoot, right? So you have only one subject, no? You can have one or more than one also word as a subject, even for predicate. You can have one word or more than one word as your predicate, okay? And then we studied about subject word. Okay, we studied about a subject word. What do you understand by subject word? The definition is there in your book only. The most important word in the sentence is your subject word. Okay, now I told you to do the exercises from page 9 and page 10 under practice number A. Many of you have sent me your work, okay? Very good. Others, please send it to me, okay? And then I will give you the correct answer so you can do it in your copy, okay? So I hope you've understood what is a sentence, and I hope you've understood what is a subject and a predicate. Yes? Okay, so if you go to page number 8, okay, the highlighted parts, that means this is your subject, okay? The definition is there in page number 9. The part of the sentence that performs the action is called the subject. Like this, okay? And the definition for predicate is the part of the sentence that tells us what the subject is or does. So what is the dog doing? Barking. So this becomes your predicate. It can be one word, more than one word, both for subject and predicate. Okay, I hope this is clear, right? Now, if you go to page number 10, okay? If you go to page number 10, B, arrange these group of words to form sentences, then punctuate and identify the subject and the predicate of each sentence. So, B1, okay. Now leave room. Now, these are your group of words. But is it a proper sentence? No, it is not a proper sentence, because though it is a group of words, it does not make sense, right? You cannot understand. So now if I write, now is it a sentence? Yes, it is a sentence, because you can understand that, you can make it, it makes sense, right? It has a complete meaning. So leave the room right now. Okay, if you notice, starting is capital, okay, and I've ended with a full stop. Okay, so this is how you're supposed to do. A punctuate means, you know, if it's a full stop, question mark, exclamation mark, all that you have to put. Okay, so I want you to do from 2 to 10. Do it first, as I told you, first do it in your rough copy. Okay, so after you do it, and when I give you the answers, then check with your answers, cross check, refer, you know, and then you do it in your fair copy. Okay, your literature, language fair copy. Okay, now I want you to do C also. I'll just show you one. Okay, provide the meaningful subjects or predicates for these sentences. So number one, so this is your sentence that is given here. So if you notice here, the predicate is there, but do you have a subject? No, you don't have a subject. So you have to write the subject. So what can you write? Who escaped? Who escaped from the jail? Who goes to jail? Prisoners, convicts, right? So you can write, the prisoner. The prisoner escaped from jail. So what are you adding? You have to write the subject. Okay? So I hope you can do this. If you go to number 6, the subject is given, you have to write the predicate. Okay, this is given, you have to write this. All right, so please do B and C in your rough copy. After I give you the answers, check the answers, okay, and then you please do it in your fair language copy. I'm repeating it again so you all don't have any doubts. If you see for C, you have to please send it to me, because every answer will be different. Okay, so C, you have to send it to me, so I'll correct it and I'll give you your correct answer. Okay, so I hope you've understood this. If you have any doubts, please ask me in my personal number. Okay, thank you and stay safe.